Hey, you folks, Quilladine here, and welcome to our Wednesday Civilization livestream. And today, we are going to be playing the modded Civ 5, let me get that out of the way, Canada Civilization. Because it's been there too long. There's actually like three different Canada Civilization mods out there, and I've never gotten around to playing one. And there's a great Canada map in Civ 5, which I've played on once before, and I thought, well, what better to play on the Canada map than Canada itself? Hello, everyone out there in the chat. Let me make a quick little adjustment to the screen here. Whoops. Nope, that's not what I'm looking to do at all. There we go. More like that. And there we go. Hello, everyone. Hey, Super Ride. I'm not Quill18, Alineth. Tequila. No more alien. No alien today. Alien was a temporary stream. No, this isn't an April Fool's joke. It's not. It's a legit, in hindsight, what I should have done is a Belgium mod Let's Play for April Fools, but no, this is a 100% legit stream. We might be a little goofier than on some days, but that's going to be perfectly fine. In the chat, if you pay attention, there will be a list explaining the mods, but let's go ahead and load up the game and then talk about what we're doing here. So first of all, I do have the enhanced user interface mod slash DLC thingy. I've also got Info Addicts loaded. See, I even have the Kingdom of Belgium here as an option. And then I have two Canadas. The Tale of Two Canadas. And originally I wanted to play this one here. Because it's got Mounties as a unique unit. But the problem is, it's got a Tundra start bias. And it's because its unique ability is pretty reasonable. If you have a city on or adjacent to Tundra, hey DHB, thanks for the sub, then forest tiles give you +1 food. Which, alright, that's interesting. Sure, that's Canadian-ish, maybe, I guess. The problem is, I did like 3 or 4 test starts, and in them, only one of them had any forest whatsoever. Hey, Chopper, thanks for the sub. So I think I might play this other one, this Colonius Legacies Canadian Dominion map instead, which is actually made by one of the people who's one of the mods over at reddit.com/r/civ. And it's got some voice acting and stuff like that, so that's kind of cool. So I think that's the one we're going to do. And we'll go in. So it doesn't have Mounties, unfortunately. But otherwise, it's still pretty Canadian and horrific. So let's go ahead and see. Configuring game data. Maple syrup is food. Yeah, maple syrup. Real maple syrup. None of that, like, generic pancake syrup or whatever, which is basically just corn syrup. Actual maple syrup. Okay. I'm going to set up the game. So we want to go and be Lester B. Pearson, Keepers of the Peace. Mounted units can temporarily claim neutral land and generate +2 happiness. If N generate +2 happiness of garrison. Think garrison is inside a city. So they can give you happiness inside of cities. Mounted units can claim temporary land. Upon declaring friendship, Canada and their friend gain +1 delegate in the World Congress. Maybe we'll play a diplomatic victory. We'll see how it goes. You never want to decide what your victory condition is before you go into the game itself. We're going to go immortal difficulty and the map. So this is part of the Scrambled Nations DLC. We're going to play the Canada map, which I've played on once before. It's basically a giant Pangea, except it doesn't wrap around. So that's important, right? If you're on the right side or the left side, you're just, you know, you can't go any further than that. So that makes a big difference. So Navy is even less important on this map than an average Pangea, which I guess makes sense playing as Canada. Navy's not really, you know, a big part of our world conquest plans. I mean, what world conquest plans? I have no idea. The landscape is like, it's semi-randomized. So it's not going to be exactly the same, like, outline every time. But also the resources get shuffled around. You even get World Wonders and all that. Like, it plays like a standard Civ 5 map, except it's kind of shaped like Canada. So let's go ahead and start that up. Do-do-do-do. You shall apologize your enemies to death. That's right, professional memester. One of the greatest and most influential of all the Canadian leaders. As Prime Minister, your efforts to bring about peace for your nation set the tone of Canada on the world stage. Under your guidance, I know it's quiet. Canada adopted universal health care, ended the death penalty, and became the first country in the world to allow race-free immigration. Your experience fighting in the world wars led you to champion the cause of peace. And after avoiding the Vietnam War and helping end the Suez Canal crisis,
look at where it put us.
The Nobel Prize for Peace in 1957.
You had literally saved the world.
Canada!
Right Honorable Prime Minister, your people look to you for leadership. The world is a violent place, filled with ambitious leaders with unscrupulous tactics.
I know it's quiet. The rest of the game is louder.
A leader who understands the realities of war and peace, who will push for diplomatic solutions wherever it is possible, unify our allies, stymie our enemies, and forge a civilization that can stand the test of time.
Yeah. All right, we'll talk about the country in a second. You know how I said that, like, the other Canada civilization has a, like, horrendous tundra bias? I gotta say, there's a lot of deer around. Now, if we trap this, so we'll get the, how much will this be? The camp will give plus one hammers. Do we get an additional food when we improve it? Like, this is crazy. Are we going to start with this? Desert hill down there. Well, it makes sense. Tundra is basically like a desert, but cold. Do we start with this? Do we want to reroll? Let's do a... Okay, I'm not planning on doing quite as many straw polls and stuff as our Beyond Earth game, for example. But this one is a good question. This start? Question mark. Keep it. Reroll. We'll just take a second to hit the button. All right. Start poll. Bam. Who dat? Hey, Jezegaya. Thanks for the resub. I think it's a resub. You can just hit restart game here, and it'll keep all your options. It'll just roll the map again and drop you somewhere else. Hey, Super Peast. My God. Even like I can't tell from the chat how people want to go. It's like a mixed bag between keep it and reroll it. Okay, keep it has a slight lead. 54%. See, here's the problem, I gotta say, with these live streams, is I like to poll people, but I'm not always convinced they're making the best decision. They're making awesome decisions. So this, we might lose the game, but we are gonna keep this tundra start because it's a little bit crazy, and why not? All right, we're going to have to, like, these tiles are fine. I guess two tiles are okay. No, they're crap. This is so bad. Oh, man, we might have to start with a worker. The people have spoken. I got to learn to not listen to people anymore because you guys are bad for me. So, I mean, normally you go with the monument start. Right, so you can get a social policy as quickly as possible. But I'm really, really tempted to say we have to start with a worker. Although we don't have tech for it yet. What do we need to build our camps? Son of a bitch, this is going to be brutal. We need to go all the way to trapping. And no one starts with that. You go pottery. That's the standard start. You go monument first, you go pottery, so you can get an early shrine, start your religion progress, maybe go to writing at that point. But then, so we're going to have to beeline trapping. That's going to take 26 turns to do. Right now, we're 18 turns to a worker. Like, the tiles we're working are awful. Technically, We can go monument first. We can go monument into worker. This is going to be so bad. Let me check the poll again. Nope, 57% keep it. Listen, we're Canadians. We're strong, hardy people. We don't apologize for nothing. Except we do. Where the hell am I? Am I in the far northwest? Am I... Well, I'm not by the James Bay or anything like that. That's what I'm thinking. I'm thinking I'm like... In the Yukon slash, I think maybe Alaska is technically on this map. I should probably start by going down, but I'm going to assume it's a dead end up here. I'm just going to peek up a little bit more just to get a bit of a goody hut. All right, that works out. Go for the Tundra Pantheon. Yeah. Although our religion is going to be delayed a bit. Hello, free culture. Does that change our approach here? We may not need to rush this monument anymore. Let's do it anyway. What we really need is a faith goody hut. Because if we get a faith goody hut, and yeah, it ends there, so we're not going to go. If we get a faith goody hut, then it'll help us get a pantheon sooner. And yeah, we do need the tundra thing, whatever it is. I don't remember what it's called. Is it like tundras without forest, tundras that aren't improved? Some damn thing like that. Could it be on an island? Probably not. Again, this is the... let me move some of that in front of the main map. This is the Canada map script, and it's not really islandy. Hey, Emma! Thanks for the resub! So, we're going to go tradition, because tradition is still one of the strongest picks for all kinds of reasons. There's something you said about Liberty for, you know, rapid expansion. It's not bad. Liberty is not bad, but tradition tends to be, like, really good. It gives us a lot more starting culture as well. It's this landed elite is really strong. The monarchy is really nice. Autocracy helps you build wonders forever, not just within the first couple eras. And when you finish tradition, you have the ability to faith buy great engineers, which helps you get the late game wonders. At high difficulty, you don't tend to get early game wonders, but late game wonders are still very important, and this helps you get those, for example. The big draw with Liberty is, yes, you get the free worker and the free settler. Obviously very good. Plus, you can build them a little bit faster, which is nice. Especially if you're playing on bigger maps that don't have that many civilizations on them. This can help you spam them out a lot faster. And when you finish it, you do get a free grace person of your choice, which generally used to get a great engineer so that you can get a wonder like early that's timed well. There's a possibility of getting like a Petra, for example, with this. But we're going to go tradition. Infinitech thinks I'm in northern Quebec, which is possible. So this would be sort of the James Bay... something like that, the Hudson Bay, and then over here would be sort of the Atlantic-ish, where I don't know, there might still be a sea name over there. Got a few desert tiles, well-known Canadian desert, obviously. We have the prairies. All right, there's another goody hut. I'm going to hit this hill first because I can get the goody hut next turn no matter what. This will give us vision. All right, some mountains over here. If we get some resources over here, we might be able to tuck in a good city with some decent science. Come on. Okay, plus one pop is definitely not bad. Again, I'm really hoping for the religion, for the faith goody hut. Oh no! Come on! I hate being close to these guys. I mean, I guess it's appropriate for the map, you know, to have some Native Americans. But what a pain. Hey, why me, 95? Thanks for the sub. They take up so much space. They're also quite powerful. They're gonna be a bit of an issue. So yes, we've expanded to there, but we're still just working the food resource. Not that they're particularly food rich, but what can we do? Shoshone, no. I mean, it could be worse. We could be next to, like, the Greeks or something. Mount Kilimanjaro. It's got three food. It's very good. The free altitude promotion. We got fish on the coast. I'm convinced that we are in British Columbia here, by the way. I'm thinking this was, like, Alaska, Yukon, British Columbia. Okay, we want this. It's one of the rare world wonders that gives you food. I mean, it's not like... Whoa, that's going to be a creeper explosion. Woo! DHB88. Oh, thank you very much. Pick yourself up a bottle of Balvenie on me. I think Balvenie is one of the types of scotch that I can get here. They don't have a huge selection, but I think the Balvenie is often available. I was worried there wasn't going to be any more Civ 5 videos because Beyond Earth coming out. Keep up the great work. Yeah, I mean, we'll probably still do some Beyond Earth in the future, but I mean... Civ 5. Like, classic Civ is still Civ. In fact, there'll probably be some Civ 4 soon. I've got that craving going on. Okay, let's go and pick up our altitude training. Boom! By going adjacent like this. 10% bonus combat strength when fighting on hills. Double movement in hills. Wonderful. If we can get all our people to have that promotion, it'll be fantastic. If we are on the West Coast as opposed to Quebec, but I think we're on the West Coast, we will be very protected on one flank. Also, this marble is going to be quite nice. Enemy, very good. Culture is going to be good. First Pantheon has gone by. Yes, do we have horses? There are horses here. All right. Goddess Protection. Oh, the crap Pantheon. Oh, thank you, AI. I'm so happy you took a shitty one first. There's one for camps as well, even if we don't take the Tundra Pantheon. There's one for camps. We got some bison, some silk. Oh, right here is what I'm thinking. Probably here. So that we can improve the fish. We get to work all these tiles. We would get to work Mount Kilimanjaro. The only downside is we wouldn't be adjacent to this. We wouldn't be able to build an observatory. But I don't see us wanting to build adjacent to Mount Kilimanjaro. I think we gain more from being coastal, even though the coast isn't terribly important on this map. The hill movement. It's like having a scout now. This is fantastic. Still hoping for a faith pop building. We'll see how it goes. Ottawa's going to grow again. I mean, I got to say one thing. It's growing pretty well. Forty Creek Whiskey. I think I have. When am I going to play more Alien Isolation? I'm not sure yet. I think we'll move inland, and I'll sort of... Oh, he's down here. For son of a bitch. For son of a bitch. Who's that? Tenshi, thanks for the sub. Our ability to get this site is going to be very, very hard with the Iroquois down here. Or the Shoshone down here. Wow. Alright, adopt policy. Oligarchy. Oh yeah, because that's a hill. We might just have to stand around here and be prepared to block any settler. Especially if they're not escorted. We don't have to worry about that quite yet, but soon. Very soon. It's mostly going to be dead end. Let's go over here. Got some furs. Oh, we never talked about our civilization powers. So let's do that now. Civilizations and leaders, Canada. Okay, so we're playing as the Dominion of Canada. Our leader is Lester B. Pearson. His ability, the Keepers of the Peace, mounted units can apparently temporarily claim neutral land and generate +2 happiness if they're garrisoned in a city. And when we declare war or friendship, we and our friend both get an extra delegate in the World Congress. I assume we lose it when we go back to peace. We'll see how it goes. And the Canadian abilities here is we've got 3 different uniques, but no buildings. We've got the Great Voyager, which replaces the Great Merchant. So apparently you can convert it into a caravan, which, and it can even go above your max trade routes if you want, which is kind of interesting. Hey, HeartMath, thanks for the sub. Or you can use it on a tile to generate furs in that tile, which is kind of interesting. And apparently they can instantly move between your cities. Look at some fur traders and stuff. That's kind of cool. We've got garrison artillery, deals double damage from within forts and citadels, and can repair damage improvements and build forts, unlike the can, which it replaces. So, I mean, it's basically just a cannon, although if we can get, like, workers on the front line building forts, or if we pop some great generals for citadels, it can do some ridiculous amount of damage, which is cool. And then finally, Avro Arrow. This is entirely the wrong picture for the Avro Arrow. The Avro Arrow was basically triangle-shaped. It was a revolutionary air fighter that there's great documentaries on it about it getting canceled in very sort of sketchy ways. Looks amazingly cool and brings with it the ghosts of conspiracy theories, unlike the fighter which it replaces. Does it literally have the same stats? No, wait. The jet fighter has a range combat of 75. Can I not go back? The Avro Arrow... No, I must have clicked on Upgrade 2. Upgrade 2. Derp. Fighter. Okay, 45. Range of 8. Oh, it doesn't go back properly. 45. Range of 8. I think they're exactly the same unit. Deception 100. Air sweep. Air recon. Bonus versus helicopters. And 375. It has exactly the same stats as the regular fighter. It just looks cooler. Okay. I'm okay with that. Really? Oh, there's forest there, so I can't get through it. That's a shame. So we're going to get a little bit more over here. Then I'm going to go and try to guard that spot if we can. Go on the hill. All right. Borders of Ottawa have grown. We still don't have good tiles to necessarily work. You're going there. We have no other 2 food tiles. I'm going to have to buy one right now. Let's buy that over there. There we go. Keep the food going. I might want to accelerate the worker. Yeah, we're going to do this. Obviously, we're stagnating our growth right now. 15 turns. Yeah, we're going to go with this. We're going to get the worker out right away so we can start building those camps. Don't know why we fell behind in our production here. I guess because we've never produced any extra hammers. That's true. Kept expecting the worker to come a little bit sooner. Let's check this. Okay. And yeah, we're gonna go stand like on this hill over here. Immortal difficulty AIs can get a settler out pretty damn fast. Pantheon founded. Stone Circles. One of the best pantheons, in my opinion. Although not one we're interested in. We're going to hate each other anyway. Yoink! I've liberated this worker, you guys. Even brute beasts and wandering birds do All right, camp, good. Choose research, pottery. So weird to not start with pottery right away, but I think it's all right. So we've got to move together so I can escort this guy back. Can we give our worker high altitude training? Does that work? Nope. That was a good idea. Borders of Ottawa have grown. They've taken in some more furs. Barbarian over here. Next policy. All right, so legalism doesn't help us right now, but it will give us a pantheon in our capital later, and it will certainly give us some monuments in our following cities, which is good. We're mostly rushing towards landed elite over here. So yeah, we're just going to escort our worker. I guess I can afford probably to rest one turn here. Oh no, that's not a hill, so never mind. I'm going to say we can catch up. So we didn't need to build our own worker, apparently. Massive P-Hag! Thanks for the sub. Dun, dun, dun. We're going to go generally that way. This tundra start is so weird. I'm kind of happy we did it. It's going to be interesting. I got to say, our capital is very protected. The problem will be potentially reinforcing our companion city over here, which is going to be fairly far away. Here, we'll scooch up one more. There we go. That way you'll be able to rest next turn. Okay. You are going to make me one warrior so that we can get a little bit more area control. And then when you hit population 7, which I can reset these tiles, when you hit population 4, not 7, you can start on our first settler. So it's just going to be a 2-1 tile. God, these are going to suck. Worst capital ever. What pantheon? God King. Okay. Which is fine. That's the generic one. If nothing else ever fits, it's like, well, at least it gives you a little bit of everything to start off with. Do, do, do. Ah, a peace treaty? That sounds good. It was all a terrible misunderstanding. I thought I knew this guy. He looked like Bob. Alright, that's enough escorting. Next turn, I'll just send my guy back to guard this area. We might have to declare war on these guys again. Although, I just realized, if they send someone out here before 10 turns have gone by, I'm not going to be able to declare war to eat their settler. That will be terrible. I don't know if we need the early archery. It'd be nice to get writing going, but we're not going to have that many barbarian problems, but we might have a little bit. I'll tell you what, I'll pick up a writing first, but then we'll pick up archery. And then it'll probably be a rush towards construction for our composite bowmen. Oh, there we go. Damn barbs. I'm just going to wait a turn here. He can't bombard me from where he is. I'm just going to heal up. Now, if there's some barbarians in this area, that can slow down the Shoshone, and that's not necessarily a bad thing. Okay, let's smack on this guy. Wow, and he can bombard me. Hand axes are a big pain in the ass to fight as opposed to brutes, because they can't heal, so how do we take so much damage? Well, alright, I guess we just have to run away then. Alright, yeah, all it added was the extra hammer. Oh, this is going to be bad. Why do I listen to you people? We should have just re-rolled. This is going to be fine. Oh, man. You just rest up here. I mean, we have to improve the terrain just for it to be, like, vaguely reasonable. Doesn't even make it good. It just makes it acceptable. Oh, there we go. I'm happy I popped out this other warrior so that we can protect our workers. Let's get the shrine going. Once that's done, we'll work on the settler. Let's go over here for the flanking bonus. Great library has already been built. Oh man, we should just restart. Oh, why don't, like, I get convinced to do these terrible starts when I'm streaming. It's not good for me. You are gonna go up here next. Improve some more deer. We might want to park someone up in this area too to prevent any barbarians from spawning here. and giving us a hard time.
Pew!
You are going to walk into friendly territory so you can heal up. I think these guys can only move one. No, they can move two. Well, we can kill it in return. We're not going to lose anyone. Oh, and you can move to there, so. Did you finish this camp? He can't reach you because of the enemy territory thing, so no, you're fine. He'll probably tear up my camp. There it is. Scumlord. Rest up. Okay, the peace treaty has expired. We gotta go and make sure we block that city location in a second here. So that's improved. So that's got the camp. That's got the camp. Yeah, so go up there. Because we can see the archer, I bet you this guy will every turn will stop. I would happily sell you an embassy. You already... We basically know where our land is. I don't think it's going to make much of a difference. And I'll take the money. Alright, writing is done. We'll give you drill for the rough promotion. Get you to fortify a little bit. You go and improve that. Just let this guy heal another tick. And then we'll go and guard that spot there. I'm going to call this one good enough. Although there might be a Bombarian encampment over there. Never mind. Let's let heal up for full. And we can also move out together. About to hit the next pop. One turn away from finishing that shrine. The turn after that, it will start the settler, which is good. Landed elite. More food in the capital. Which is going to help us build our settler a little bit faster, which is nice. You're working, well, the only tiles that are vaguely reasonable. So do that. They ain't great, but there's something. Hey, Freddy Firecaster, thanks for the resub. Always appreciate your support. Also, I believe you have been a dwarf in Dwarf Fortress before. I think so. At this point, I'm basically going to automate these guys. It's kind of a no-brainer what to do. They'll just go and improve the furs, which is fine. Actually, hold on. We might want to make sure that it improves or fixes the deer first, which it probably was going to. But we're going to make sure. Hey, Zealous Gamer, thanks for the sub. Whoop. Who dat? Gustavus Adolphus, the Lion of the North. Nice to see you, buddy. We're losing money right now? Yeah, we are. And that's with the trade. Alright, well, there's that barbarian camp. Although, it's relatively easy to kill the archers. Assuming nothing else spawns right this second, and then soon we'll have help from over here. We've completed our own archery. It's interesting they didn't bombard us. Okay. I think bronze working to reveal it, plus mining is on the way to construction. Construction is going to be a relatively high priority for us. Because there might be some early warfare. The question is, when do we go for the National College? Do we go two cities? Three cities? We need calendar just to like get up in that point at some point. We would like some fishing boats as well. Because we want to be able to hook up these pearls. And down here we'll need... There's fish here. Fish here. We might want a relatively early fishing. Our happiness is okay right now. Hey, the damned. Thanks for the sub. We've got time. I think we'll want three cities. I think we might want to settle over here. We could just go two cities, build up an army, and go and trash them. But I think we've got time for three. So, and there was marble over here. You know what? Let's not go sailing. We'll go bronze working, try to reveal some iron, and then we'll go up to construction. Oh, we need the wheel for that as well. Because masonry will unlock the quarry, which will get some extra happiness, and then it'll probably be up to philosophy. And then we'll backfill our sailing at that point. Something of that nature, I think, will be okay. You go and improve that. Although I have to be careful. There'll probably be more barbarians coming from over here soon. You've completed that. Lovely. Come over here. Temple of Artemis, Stonehenge. Pretty standard. Not really something that we can normally get on Immortal difficulty, and I wasn't looking for them. Actually, he can pretty much kill that on his own. I'll go here just in case it spawns another barbarian. We'll need some extra muscle. But I still generally want to make my way south. Aha! See? Called it. I think if we do this, I don't think the spearman can kill it. You know, let's play it safe. Let's rest a turn. And then do it. That's been repaired. Lovely. We'll probably build an archer after this and then go into our library. I don't know. It's hard to decide. Pop that. Get some gold. A little minor defeat over there. I think that's okay to accept. If you get optics, you can pick up those ancient ruins north of Ottawa. There's a barbarian there. There was. Probably we don't have to rush to it too quickly. We're going to take a double drill. Because this is a lot of rough terrain. And I'm actually going to head this guy down here to keep an eye on things before I get him to rest and heal up. You, rest, since the barbarian spearman cannot. It can't heal. I'm hoping it attacks me. Pantheon. Oh. Which one? Shoshone have gone for God of the Sea. That's interesting. Are they coastal down here? And just rest a sec here. Ooh, I'd like to finish it off there, but we'll win, but there's a chance we'll lose. So I guess we'll just finish him off that way. That's fine. You rest. Again, I'm hoping to keep an eye on things over here, but... Pointy of Sticks. Della's got 218, but again, this is a mortal difficulty. They started some extra stuff. Also, the start is terrible. But we'll make do with it. No, I need another defender up here. We're going to have to go archer and then go for our library. And the granary, we probably... Oh, yeah, granary helps on deer. We do have to get the tech flowing. We're going to library first and then granary. That'll be okay. I guess rest. And here, I'll just automate these guys. There's not really anything they could do wrong. Although, right here, I'm going to temporarily move you out of the way so I can put the settler over there. Since I don't trust this area, but this area is currently clear. In fact, I can maybe do this for a little bit of vision here. I think we'll be okay. Sweden's already entered the classical era. All right, it's fine. You rest a turn. You, I can automate you again. Sorry to distract you from your job there, Mr. Worker, but I had to come through with a settler. All right. You better not declare war on me for my settler here. That would be a very rude thing to do. Could you imagine declaring war on someone for their non-combat unit? That would just be very mean. All right. Granary first. People want granary first. Oh, already got a sale for furs? Very nice. I don't suppose I can just get 7 gold per turn. I don't care about your embassy. All right. Higher population is fair. We've got the happiness for it. We'll put the granary first. Go there. What I'll actually do is scooch this one forward and then move this one up. Terracotta army's already been built. That's pretty early for the Terracotta army, I think. I don't think they got a lot of benefit from it, which is kind of interesting. Okay, so I'm still thinking this is the spot to be. It's got the river thing, it's got the water access, even gets the silk. Yeah. Definitely the way to go. Although whenever the game agrees with me, I always get a little nervous. This is a long... Shit. Of course. Of course! You douchebag AI. I can settle here. I can, although I don't get... One turn away. One turn away. I think I'm still going to settle. I might still settle here. 1, 2, 3. But I can't settle there. Oh my god. That's really where I want to be. If I settle here, it's a good place to run an attack. This start is just so bad. The thing what you want to do with a start is you want to start with a tile that's got three good things in it. See, like, this is three good things, but we had to improve it. You want to start with at least one tile next to your capital that's got that. Our start is so slow. I don't know why I bother listening to anyone. Like, why would I do votes? It's such a bad start. It's like, oh, it's fine. People want me to stay here. It's such shit. So I settle here. We lose the river thing. Settle here and then just go and burn down Goshut. 1, 2, 3. We could settle on the desert hill, which actually I think would be even better. We get more of a production boost. If we don't get the river, that'll work. And we technically get the deer and the horses eventually from here. I don't want to move around too much. There's going to be a not more ideal spot, but let's go there. And we should be able to build up military forces relatively quick. That was one of the reasons I said, with, like, as opposed to the On Earth stuff, I was like gonna do less votes with Civ 5, because it's like, it'll go better if I don't. And the one vote, I mean, it's cool, it's worth checking out the start, but I did call it that we were almost certainly going to lose as a result. You're very far away. Can we get mutual embassies? I want to see where you are. I'm not gonna restart now, and that's the problem. Once you commit, you go. I'm not going to be a wimp and restart just because, you know, one little thing didn't go according to plan. But this start, we do know, is horrible. We do have iron right there, which is a thing. But yeah. Over here, we're going to get a... we might go straight into a barracks. No, I think we're going to get a granary first to help get a little bit of free food over here. Something like granary into barracks into just pump out military units. And then we're going to go and try to attack the Shoshone. Yeah, we're not going to be able to pull that off. We're not going to be able to pull that off because they're on Immortal AI. They're going to have too many troops for a long time. Are we permanently too slowed? We might be okay. I'll still start with the granary, though. And then we'll go and see if we can hunt down whatever barbarian encampment is over here. Yeah. Can I get more money? Whatever. We'll take what you've got. We can always trade the horses to someone else. I mean, by having two workers spending an unbelievable amount of time improving the terrain over here, we've brought this terrain up to, it's not the worst. Although it pretty much is. The problem is these tundra furs are just shit tiles. Even improved, there's no reason to ever work these tiles. One food, three gold. We can't play this game. It's too horrible. It's too horrible. If I'd gotten this site, that would have been very different, because getting this wonder would have been useful. Plus, it'd be a great site to run up against the Shoshone. I think we do have to restart. I'm going to just go ahead and do it, you guys. Sorry to everyone who doesn't want me to, but the city location is just too bad. The reason I didn't use the other, like, I like the other Canada mod better because it has Mounties, but the reason I didn't pick it is because it has a Tundra bias, and Tundra tiles are just the worst. So we're gonna stick with the non-Tundra specific Canada, but we're gonna reroll. Try to get something more reasonable. Do setup game. And I don't know why it keeps resetting it to this. I guess that's because the single player, that's the last thing I loaded up to test out something. Essentia, can I get you to, hang on a sec. Scramble Nations, Canada. I was going to try to do a thing. The reason those settings are there is to see if on Prince playing as Egypt, if you could do something like build all the wonders or something like that. All right. Well, still near the tundra, but this is an infinitely less shit start. Ah, there we go. This is plains. I was worried it's going to be tundra wheat. Yeah, I don't even know if that's a possibility. Tundra wheat would have been less than good, but this much stronger. We're going to settle in place over here. We're going to do a turn one save here as well. Okay. Monument start. It's just much more standard. Pottery first, because that's the best way to go. There we go. Got forests. And we seem to be in the middle of stuff, which might be a little scarier. But we're not, like, in Alaska behind a row of mountains with zero accessibility. Even building units from our capital to try to engage the Shoshone would have taken them a million years to be able to actually reach the front. Warfare wasn't really an option for us. Like, that's the way you recover from any sort of problems. And against Immortal and Deity AI, you have to bring the war to them. They start off with such a huge edge that the only way to equalize it is usually with a little bit of warfare. And with our capital being so far from the front, and our capital is going to be our biggest production site, we would have never gotten around to being able to war properly. Interesting. Are we... Oh! Oh, we can see the edge of the map. Okay. So, we are in the far eastern reaches of Canada right now. This might be Quebec-ish, you know, New Brunswick, Nova Scotia, Labrador, Prince Edward Island, somewhere all along here, probably. We might even be in Labrador at this point. It's hard to tell. I like all the forests. You think this start is bad too? Well, this start is not great, but it's like freaking far from the last one. Because one thing to recall here is right away we've got two tiles. In fact, three tiles. But within our inner ring, we have two tiles that are giving us three good production, which I tell you is core. If you can get salt, then you get crazy good stuff. Crazy good stuff. But this is like a world of difference. All of a sudden now, we've got as much food as the last start plus production. It's not even a sick good start. It's just an acceptable. It's just a reasonable, normal start. So we finished the monument. Let's get a scout out this time. Such a standard start now. Much happier. It's still junk lands. No, this is fine. I'm okay with this start. Yeah, and it's not a god start, but I'm perfectly fine with it. We got some gems over here. Pantheon, sun god. I'm going to go ahead and start smacking around this archer right away. Is he on a hill? Oh, he is. Okay. Explains why he's a little bit tougher. So now we've got another tile that's got decent work. Fine, we'll get the silver later on. Fine. I'm not a huge fan of most plantation resources because they mostly just give you more money. But that's okay. We will need... we probably want mining relatively quick to improve the silver as opposed to going for calendar. And the bonus of it is we can pick up masonry relatively easily. Plus get some extra production overall. Chop down some of these forests. I think, yeah, I'm going to go mining and then straight into masonry. Maybe just mining to start, writing, then we'll make a decision as to what happens at that point. We've got England this time. She is far, far less annoying than Shoshone, although once she gets her longbows, it's like, do not war England for a little while. Don't think he can kill me. I'm hoping not. Oh, there's a city-state there. It just expanded. We are going to have to run away, and unfortunately, I'm worried that he might be able to shoot me as I run. I could take an insta-heal over here. You know what? Let's do that. It's a little bit goofy, but... we'll clear it out and that'll be fine. Would be nice if we got in a quest there, but I'll just take that. That's not the end of the world. Okay, that scout was finished. Let's get a shrine up and running. In fact, usually what I do is I cancel the scout in favor of getting the shrine out a little bit sooner. But this is going to be okay too. I didn't even see where England went. Who's that? Grumba, thanks for the sub. And a goodie hut over there. Did we get a goodie hut already? I don't think we did we? I guess we got a map. The... Grand Mesa. Grand Mesa is okay, but is far from great, because it doesn't produce any food. That really brings down the value a fair bit. Oh, this gave us a free tech! Not a map, we got a free tech out of the thing. Nice! Again, we're going to tradition, because I like tradition. It suits my playstyle very well. We are going to rest up, since these guys can't heal. With all luck, they might, Yeah, it's fine. She's not super aggro. Where's her capital? Oh, down there. Who would have thought England have gone and set up some colonies inside of Canada? Instead of what is appropriately our land over here. Hey! Well, no, we know we're here. Just this bit kind of looks similar to the last one. Double stone, marble, more stone, more stone. I think we're going to go stone circles and try to settle over here. We're just going to have to hope that there's some food resources. Because if we got stone circles up and running, we would get crazy amounts of faith. More stone and double fish, which ain't bad. Obviously, tundra is not great. This is also where the Grand Mesa is, which is fine. Not important, although we can settle next to it, which means we'll be adjacent to a mountain. A map. Did reveal some more ruins, but we can't actually reach there at this time. Let's come down this way. Okay, working towards that shrine. That's good. We're all healed up. Although now we got two dudes to worry about for some reason. I'm actually going to move here, meet these guys first, because, yeah, they'll give me credit for killing barbarians. Hello, Melbourne. Nice to meet you. Melbourne? Depending on exactly where you're from and how you say it, there's, like, not enough letters. Alright, let's blow this guy up. Get some credit. Adopt policy. We'll grab oligarchy. Okay. We've got our writing. We don't need to rush trapping, although it will be very nice for this deer. Getting a granary in Ottawa is going to be wonderful. We don't need calendar yet, because we've got some other things to improve before then. Are you going to pick up the silver, or are we going to have to buy it? Wouldn't mind building an archer. Alternatively, getting animal husbandry so you can see if we've got any horses might be a thing, but it's not critical. Oh, I can't move you this turn. Melbourne's not going to get angry with me, I hope. There we go. No, because we're basically right there. Just going to rest a turn. Since we have to fight barbarians, I think they won't get angry with me because I'm nearby. I'm not sure. We're not going to do the Great Library because that's a trap. We will probably go to the granary right away. It doesn't have to be improved. It improves the wheat and the deer automatically. We could go straight to a worker, but I don't think we need to do that. I think the granary will effectively give us almost as much of an improvement. And then we don't have to guard it right now. Granary into worker. I think so. You just run away. Find more goody huts. Be really nice to get religion, because I want stone circles. No! Someone got stone circles. Oh, well. And we got faith! Unbelievable! One turn away. We have enough faith to get our pantheon now. We were one turn away from being able to get our stone circles. Are you kidding me? I don't even know what we want now. Something something camps? Son of a bitch! This game is intentionally trolling me now. So we can get culture and faith from wine and incense. Oh, that's dyes. That's not incense. I don't think they have anything for dyes specifically. We're not restarting. Food from camps. One, two. I guess it's only the two camps, so that's no good. We don't have jungle tiles. We do have technically some tundra without forest, but it's crap tiles. Copper iron, no. Healing, no. Fertility rates is always okay, I guess, if I have to. Wow. The natural wonder one? It's only +4 faith. Yeah, we'll have one. If we work that tile, which we might. I suppose that's reasonable. I mean, we would have gotten, what, 10 faith working all these stone sites? 12, 14 faith? Fucking hell. God King's not bad. Fertility rights aren't bad. Hey, Daff, thanks for the sub. I like to go with things that give us, like, happiness or faith primarily. I don't think one with nature is worth it. Because it's not that strong of a tile, and I don't really want to be encouraged to work it that much. I think we'll just God King. It gives us a little bit of everything, and it's fine. It's perfectly generic and boring, but that's weird. Okay. God damn, that's so frustrating. It would have been so amazing. Yay, Barbarian Camp. Woo! Because I care about that. Pop! Yeah, we don't get tons of relationship, but we get a decent amount. Oh, man! Game, listen. I mean, we still got XP from killing those barbarians. That is so tempting. It's right there. They're asking me to take their worker. Oh, they're in protection of England. Now, I don't think England will declare war on me for it, but obviously we'll get a bad modifier. And even if they declare war on me, I'm not sure what they're going to do. I don't think they'll do much. More goody huts. I apologize. We will withdraw immediately. I'm not going to... Oh yeah, I should have pieced out last turn. I forgot. I took extra bit of damage that I didn't have to do. Because you can piece out instantly with the city-states. There we go. We're fine now. Just going to move into the forest, so I'm a little more protected, even though the other way would have been a bit faster. Let's pick up that calendar. Hold on, let's pick up animal husbandry, just to reveal horses. Then pick up calendar so we can improve our plantations, work towards philosophy. Most likely we're going to want to get some construction after that, depending on how close we are to different people. Yay, another map. Well, it leads to another goody hut, or two goody huts. All right. We did get archery, yeah, good. Because I'm going to want to... Wow, got to defend Ottawa quite a bit here. I mean, they can't take Ottawa, and I don't have a worker yet, so I'm actually not really losing much. That's pretty standard. Not really anything we can do about our literacy early on versus the immortal AIs. They do start with some free tech and a pretty substantial bonus. Alright, we'll keep it safe for now. Since we don't have vision over here, then we can go straight through here, and it'll be okay. Doo-doo-doo. Pantheon of protection. Man, last time the AI took such crap pantheons, too. Doo-doo-doo. You are kind of annoying. There's another goody hut up there, which is nice. We'll run this way. More faith! Well, we might have found a religion. We might have to rest a bit before we actually go for that other one. I know, we'll try. Well, I'm happy I built the granary first as opposed to the worker. You don't have to protect the granary. And it'll still give us a lot of extra food. There we go here. Excellent. We get a policy. So we're going to take legalism, which will be handy later on. We are going to get one archer going. Probably archer, worker... library. I guess I'm going to be moving this guy into friendly territory as well. He's damaged enough that it's worth taking the extra turn to move him into friendly territory to heal up at twice the rate. Do, 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 do. Pew! Yeah, you can't get me if I come up to the hill, so that's good. Just move in here. There we go. Nice. Advanced weapons. I was really hoping for that. We're now going to rest you up. Since the last thing we want to do is lose this. He's got scout powers of improved movement, but he's an archer, which is really good. Pew! And... what? No. There we go. There's actually a chance we might die there. Let's wait one turn. I can't improve the deer yet because I don't have camp. I think what we'll do is work on the wheat and then the silver or something like that. Oh, he didn't suicide against me. I can kill him that way for the XP. Excellent. Do-do-do. All right. What does legalism give you if you already have a monument? When you discover drama and poetry, I believe it will give you a free amphitheater. I think. We'll move. Can we heal a little bit faster? Sure. We'll move into the capital and heal there because we'll get 25 per turn. I don't know. I haven't done the math to figure out if we'd actually save a turn or not. Farm it up. Food production is pretty good. We are at size 4. Okay, we'll finish the archer. We don't need the worker at that point. I'm going to cancel that worker. We're going to get a settler. Excellent. Very good. Alright, we've got to move a stacked unit, which is fine. We're going to have to figure out where we want to settle. Obviously, this is a fine spot, but it's not a priority. We're not going to cry if we lose the Grand Mesa, for example. And generally, you often want to settle sort of towards your opponent, because that's the land they're going to go. This is dark, so we don't know what's here. We might end up with a trio of cities on the coast, though. For example, if I put a city right here... yeah, that makes future placement around the Grand Mesa a little unoptimal. But it's in the short term, it's the best immediate city, potentially. I mean, don't get me wrong, this isn't bad. If we settled, say, right on this tundra here... yeah, there's 3 stones, it would work, although it'd be tundra stone, so meh, it's not terrible, but meh. But it would have the horses within its borders right away, so that's 2-in-1 tile, which is pretty good. Expanding towards the stone, that's another 2-in-1 tile. This marble over here, which also gives us happiness. It would get the 2 fish, ultimately. It's adjacent to the Grand Mesa, so the advantage to that isn't the mesa itself, but it counts as a mountain, which means we can build an observatory here. So we do this, and then just, like, build our way down the coast. I think I like that. Settle on the horses? I think settling on the horses would be ultimately a bit weaker. Yeah, it gives you the cows in the long term, but it's not so good. If you settle on the tundra, it just consumes this tundra tile, which is otherwise real crap. Yeah, I mean, I agree, the Grand Mesa is a terrible wonder, which I keep saying, and it's not really going to get anything much out of tiles up here. It's all going to be the tiles to the south. We could just skip it and go straight to, say, here. Or I could settle on the marble. Actually, what if I do that? Hey, Daff! Been watching your YouTube videos for ages. Figured it was about time I checked your live stream, so I figured why not donate as well. Thank you very much. Sort of a token of appreciation. Thanks for being awesome. No, thank you for being awesome. I like the idea of settling on the marble. Yeah, and if you settle on the tundra, it improves the terrain, because it'll give us the same terrain we have here, right? A 2-1 tile. Instead of just a 1 food tile. Wouldn't have been so bad if you had the Wonder Faith. Yeah, I'm still okay with going with the God King. I'm not going to cry about it. Settle on the dyes between the cattle and the horses. Oh, over here? Probably in the future, there'll be a settlement down here. I don't think I want to rush it. Well, maybe. Go here and then backfill in. I like coastal. I mean, we could go all the way here. Settle on dyes is fine, because plantations aren't necessarily worth that much. Gives us the gold, gives us this. Solidifies a bit of a line here that we can backfill in. Yeah, you know what? I don't mind that plan. I don't mind that plan one bit. Let's actually move the archer this way so we can get a bit of vision. We might do that. We're still 9 turns away from our actual settler, but that's okay. Hey, Malia, thanks for the sub. Also, it's been about an hour. It's definitely time for a bit of a break. So let me go ahead and do that. I can also save the game properly to make sure everything is okay. So we're going to take a short break. We'll be back in about 2 or 3 minutes, and we'll continue this game.